So audience, can you able to see it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so this is an energy yield assessment calculator, so which we developed for our own purpose. And similarly, like everyone can go with your kind of study. So if I just zoom it, you can see the kind of assumptions I have taken. So this is a plant capacity in terms of kilowatt. And this is the capacity in watts. I have calculated a 1 megawatt analysis here. And this is a solar PV rating of an individual module, 325 watts I have taken. And it's open circuit voltage, short circuit current, voltage at maximum power, current at maximum power. Okay. As in terms of electrical, this five parameters are very important. And in terms of string designs, like how many numbers of string is connected the inverter, and how many strings are there, and what is the total number of module, and what is the total array capacity I'm going to achieve out of this design. And this is the module fill factor. Fill factor is nothing but the kind of the formula is usually denoted as VMP IMP divided by VOC ISC. So it's nothing but what is the practical maximum output you are getting divided by what is the ideal maximum output you are supposed to get. So if you do that calculation, then the factor you are getting is a PV module fill factor. This fill factor is actually decides the kind of output you will get from the module. Let's say if you're having a 100 watt solar panel and your module is having a fill factor of 0.8, you will only experience maximum of 80 watts out of that module. And this fill factor and efficiency are both different parameters. It should not confuse each other, because efficiency denotes its performance, whereas the fill factor is its ability. So both are different. And next is the PV module tolerance, because in the manufacturing you may not be exactly tell that it is a 100 watt module. It depends on the kind of small variation of watts, milliwatts, or kind of thing in a single cell. But there are group of cells in a PV module. Let's say if you take this is the 325 watt solar panel, then there are 72 cells which has been assembled in a PV module. So the tolerance of 1 watt in a single cell will result in a 72 watt in its output. So that's why we cannot exactly say that what is the kind of capacity of a module. That's why the tolerance ratio is being mentioned by a manufacturer, that it may be plus or minus 5% of its thing, which means if you take a 100 watt panel, it may be a 95 watts, or it may go up to 105. So it will not be below to that or above to that limit. So the tolerance is given. But if you have a module of positive tolerance, then you may be getting more. If we have local cheap modules, they say it's 100, and if I have a tolerance ratio is more than 5%, then you will be only achieving the less generation. And whole factors like a practical derating factor, which means dust, then soiling losses, then temperature, all these things we've taken into account, and the maximum disturbance which will affect the output will be of 15%. And this is a practical array output, what you will get at the as an array output. And this is the inverter capacity, and this is the inverter efficiency, and this is what is the actual inverter peak output you are getting. So this is the technical parameters we will take into the calculation for an energy yield assessment study. Then next, what we are doing is we are assessing its generation for the entire year. So you'll see how it is happening. So you'll take the month, the PS, such as nothing but the peak sun hour. The peak sun hour is nothing but from morning 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. So that period is called as PSH, that is a peak sun hours. During that particular period only, we are assuming that the solar generation has been accounted. This 5.5, 6.4, this all denotes the the kind of PHS which is available the particular month, and this is the array output, and this is the DC energy generated, this is the AC energy generated per day, number of days in a month, and this is the energy estimated, that is the watt hour, and this is the net energy calculated. So this is the energy yield for every month, and if you all together, it will give the energy yield of a entire year. And if you calculate for per kilowatt, the actual practical output is coming around 4.57 kilowatt hour per day for a 1 kilowatt plant, which is really a good figure now. But nowadays, with improved mono PERC technology and improved inverter efficiency, we would get maximum of 5 to 5.2 as an average for the entire year. So this 4.57 kilowatt hour per kilowatt plant is an average factor of a plant for the entire year. In some, for example, in summer or in some good light conditions, it may go up to 5.5 also, but it, you will not take that as a common factor. You will only see the average factor, that average is 4.5. So anything having average of more than 4.3 is really a good and efficient system. So now we are working out so this is a graph which shows the kind of energy generation which happened for the month. You can see during March, April and May, you can see a very good kind of generation because of the good light. And again, the September and October is having a very good generation. So this is, this shows the energy yield assessment study. So these are the main parameters, technical factors involved in it. So once again, I repeat, you first calculate the plant capacity. Then what is the module you have chosen for your design? What is the electrical parameters of the module? And how you are designing the string? How many strings are there? And what is the total number of modules? And what is the fill factor of the module? What is the tolerance ratio of a module? What is the derating factor you will be considering? Which derating is nothing but the kind of disturbances which will affect the output of a module. Then what will be the practical you are getting? What is the actual you are getting after the inverter efficiency and all? So that value is actually accounted as a PV output, and that is calculated along with the peaks and hours, because what is the PSH is available, you have to multiply that with your peak output in terms of AC, and that into number of days will give the total generation in terms of whatever for 1 month. Like that, January to December, the entire year you will calculate, and if you divide with the 365 days, you will get the total output for the single day, and if you divide with the plant capacity, you will get your per kilowatt generation per day calculation here. So this is the energy yield assessment study of a normal PV solar photovoltaic grid connected, which is an on-grid system. Okay, right. So what is this? Is a technical model. This technical model is actually going to show you like what is my generation of the plant, which is going to be for the next 20 years, because any solar plants which you are taking into account for any kind of bigger projects, they will calculate the generation, they will account its income for the entire 20 years as a business model. So here we have taken into account of the PAD factor of 1% per year, which means every year I'm going to get a decrease of 1% efficiency from my plant output as a factor of derating, which is nothing but a PAD, potential induced degradation factor. So if you calculate, keep on years and years and years, you can see the kind of decline of its efficiency and what is the total lifetime energy generation which is happening out of the plant. So this is the lifetime energy generation yield study. So you should not consider
the efficiency degradation like 100%, 99, 98, 97. It is the degradation of 1% efficiency of the previous year. So it'd be 100 minus 1. And this is first year value minus 1. This is second year value minus 1. Like that you have to go. So the actual calculation of a PV module, manufacturer warranty says that the panel output of a panel, a good panel, will be achieved of up to 80% at the end of 25th year. So that is the kind of guarantee which they are, that is the performance guarantee they are giving from all the top manufacturer, which means in the first year, first day, if you test a PV module, if it gives a 100 watt output, the same module by means of continuous usage on an open environment, and if you test the same module under standard test conditions in a laboratory, and the 25th year, you will get a maximum of 80%, which means 80 watts you can able to achieve. You will not get 100% of it. So this is what you called as a performance guarantee, and this difference is happened because of the PID impact. There's a potential induced degradation impact because temperature is continuously falling over it, light is continuously falling over it, and inside the PN junction diode, millions of time electron hole per generation happens. The junction is getting a break and it goes, the electrons movement happening. So because of that, the property of silica, the efficiency of the silica material will slightly get its level low. So this is the main reason. So if you calculate a plant, then these are the main parameters you are supposed to consider. Plant capacity, what is the average generation, the number of days available to give an energy estimate, annual generation per year, cost of the system per watt, total plant cost, cost of the grid power, cost of the PPA, that is the power purchase rate, and the grid escalation factor, PID factor. Then IRR is a target of internal rate of return for an investor, and O&M cost per year, O&M cost escalation for every year, and what is the PPA period. So this will give the total output of lifetime energy, lifetime revenue, then PPA, during the PPA, how much of money has been saved from a client side, and what is the expectancy, life expectancy of a plant. So this is what actually a energy yield assessment study has been done. Hi, Mr. Sai.
Tell me, sir.
Yeah, I think I've given enough clarification for the energy yield assessment study to the audience.
Okay, sir.
Now we can start the question and answers.
Participants can answer, ask any questions regarding the topic that was discussed now. So one of the participants asked if it is right time for starting energy yield assessment study.
Right time to start energy yield assessment study. There is no such right time, but you need to consider the variables involved in the energy yield assessment study. For example, if you are going to assess a plant, you should not consider only 1 month at which you are actually inspecting the plant. You need to consider the entire 12-month thing. And also not for the 1 year, you should take the data of TMI3, that's a typical metronomical year data from a metronome or from any kind of satellite data. You can take the average values of the last 5 years or last 10 years and you can put that into your technical considerations.
What is the next question?
No more questions, sir.
Okay. And if any doubts, any clarifications, or any interaction has to be made from my side, you can just contact me. And Mr. Sai, you just share my contact to them so that
we
can connect.
Sure, sir.
Okay.
So shall we close the session, sir?
Yeah. We can.
Personally thank on behalf of the management as well as AAA department for providing a useful information about the various parameters involving solar photovoltaic cell systems. And thank you for again gracing the occasion, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thanks.